David here.
Love and freedom to you all. It's David. I've got my placard with me, as you can see. And I'm outside Southwark Crown Court, as you can see. There we go, Southwark Crown Court. We're getting around, we're getting all touristy. Because today and for the next couple of weeks, Nacho, who is from our freedom movement, is facing trial. It was a charge in place for him on carrying an offensive weapon, which at the time was batteries for his megaphone. So he was arrested in Hyde Park back in 2021, following a very, very peaceful freedom rally. The whole day was peaceful. And it was actually the biggest freedom rally and march we've had against the COVID restrictions and lockdowns and impositions probably since the whole thing began, actually. Placard's falling down, let's pick it up. And so basically the charge was dropped due to lack of evidence. The batteries for his megaphone were not perceived by the court as an offensive weapon. So thankfully that charge was dropped, but apparently he's also being charged with on a conduct apparently of promoting violent disorder, which again is complete nonsense. Bear in mind he was peaceful, everybody that day was peaceful apart from the police, who waded in on peaceful demonstrators as they were performing their Jam for Freedom music act in Hyde Park. So the only violence that day was coming from the police. But anyway, Nacho is in court until the end of next week. Crown Court, can you believe it? Crown Court, which is just beggars belief. Bear in mind, there's all these heinous criminals out there in the world today who are running around committing violence, acts of violence, assault, all sorts of dreadful behaviours. And yet they got Nacho in Crown Court in Southwark, who is a very peaceful man and was promoting a peaceful cause. There we go. So I was hoping to see more people up here. I think I've come up here the wrong time, unfortunately, because the usual crowd aren't here at this particular time. This is Wednesday. A lot of them were here on Monday and Tuesday, but I'm here anyway. I'll hang around and just hold the line on my own with my placard, love and freedom, isn't it? And if people turn up, that's fantastic. If they don't, it's okay. I'm here anyway. And it's going to just make the most of being here, really. So love and freedom to you all. Keep your spirits high, guys. Keep your energy high, and don't let these people grind you down, because they're going to find lots of ways to grind you down. They're going to find all sorts of ways to grind you down and dampen your spirits, whether it's through the corrupt media, whether it's through threats, fines, whatever else, worse even. But you need to keep your energy high, guys, because it's all about energy. And the more you smile, the more you laugh, the more you hug, the more you kiss your loved ones, the more they hate it. It's all about trying to lower our energy, lowering our frequency. So keep your energy high, guys. And yes, don't let them grind you down, guys. We're not out of the woods yet. Some of you think we're out of the woods. Some of you think we're free again, simply because the lockdown's been lifted. We're not free, okay? We're not free. They're thinking of new variants all the time. The latest one is, I can't remember what it's called actually, but it's a new variant which is named after Greek mythology, a two-headed dog in Greek mythology. I'm going to share a link anyway shortly. Huh? a two-headed dog. In Greek mythology, it's the latest variant's name. I need to check for my video. I looked at it this morning. The one before that was Kraken variant, which again is from Greek mythology. A huge sea monster, octopus that swallows up ships. That was the last variant. That's still hanging around, Kraken variant. We've also had, what else have we had? We've had Omicron, Deltacron as well. The Delta variant. Yeah, don't forget the Delta variant. That was an early one.
Close the door, they're coming in the window. Close the door, they're running up the stairs. Close the door, they're hanging on the ceiling.
We've also had, oh my gosh, there's so many of them. I'll share them in a video anyway, because I just can't keep up with them, really. It's all complete nonsense. But it's all designed to scare people. The good thing is that most people are realizing now that this is a load of nonsense. And people are actually starting to question their lives day by day. People have had the jibby jabbies are starting to question whether it was right to have these jibby jabbies, because they're just creating new viruses, new illnesses, new variants, just to get you to plead for more jibby jabbies.
People say, careful, Alistair, you're starting to sound like an anti-vaxxer. That's what they say. Listen, let me just break it down for this guy, right? I am not an anti-vaxxer. And I'm not anti-vaccine. I am anti-this vaccine. Okay? I've never looked into vaccines before, but this one, I'm fucking looking into intent. It's like, imagine you went to Chessington World Adventures, right? You went to Chessington World Adventures. You went on all the rides except for the bubble words. And your friend was going around saying, oh, he's anti-right. Because I treat vaccines exactly the same way I treat theme park rides. When I decide whether I want to have a go on them. Do you know what I did? I have a look at the people that have just come off. Right? I say to myself, what do they look like? They look like they've had a good time, or are they coming out of there like, whoa. Would you go on a theme park ride that was so dangerous that if you'd been on it, you had to wait 8 weeks before you go back on it again?
So they'll create the problem and then they'll create the solution. It's the same old formula, it's been going on for decades. Some may say centuries, really. But unfortunately, some people are still falling for it. So I'm not asking you to believe me, guys. You can believe what you like. This is a free country-ish. But do question things. That's all I ask. Please question things. Don't just take what the media tells you. Oh, dear. My placard's had enough for today. Just question things, guys, basically. So another thing I want to mention whilst I'm here on my own is I've just been to four different coffee shops in London Bridge. Just get myself a cappuccino, not much to ask for. And the coffee shops were only taking card. And I said to them, why are you taking card? And one of them had a manager and he said, well, you know, since COVID, you know. And I'm like, yeah, but it's all, you know, we moved on from that, surely. And he just laughed and said, I'm sorry, we can't take cash. And the other two shops didn't really know why they weren't taking card, but they were just saying, sorry, it's cash rather. And they just said, I'm sorry, we can't take card, cash rather. So I'm getting myself confused now. Both begin with C. So basically they refused to take my cash, which was a bit of a swizz. And the fourth place was so embarrassed about me trying to give them cash that they actually gave me a free coffee. They said they'd rather give me a free coffee and lose business that way than take my cash, which was pretty much the exact change in my hand. But there you go. Stand and deliver. So this is another thing we need to be mindful of, guys. It's erosion of freedom day by day. You may think it's all okay. You may think, oh, it's convenient to not use cash. You know, I've got my card handy. I've got my watch handy. I've got my Apple Pay handy. Oh, it's so easy. All I do is tap and go. But you do need to understand, if these machines go down, if these electronic card machines go down, which they're more likely than not they will go down, you and I are stuffed. And not only that, but these businesses are stuffed. Because these card machines, these payment card machines they relied on to take your currency, it's no longer going to work. Take away that plastic money. Keep away from plastic money. So all I ask for you is try and insist on paying by cash. If you can't pay by cash, one thing you could do is just walk out. Say, okay, I'm not giving you my business because you're not taking my cash. Another thing you can do, which is still legal, is to put the cash on the counter and take your drink anyway, because you're not refusing to pay. In a day, you're still paying. And my placard keeps... You're not refusing to pay, you're still paying. But you're just not accepting their card payment scheme. So they can't say, oh, you didn't pay, oh, we're calling the police. At the end of the day, you have paid. It's okay, you've paid your money. You've done what's legal, because cash is still legal tender. They cannot refuse your cash. Another thing which I've done, which I don't really recommend, but if you're really desperate to make a point, another thing you can do is just by getting a note out of your pocket. Like, if you go for to buy a coffee, get yourself a note out, like a £5 note, even a £10 note, even a £20 note if you're really brave, and just stick it on the counter and say to them, okay, if you can't take my cash, yeah, I'll take keep the change. You clearly can't handle change, so you better take my change. Because that will embarrass them. When they take a whole £20 note or £10 note even for your one coffee, the staff will be so embarrassed by the fact that they can't give you any change. That hopefully it will make them think twice. Maybe it will make them think, you know, I better talk to my manager about this because this is silly. Well, I've done that more than once now where I bought myself a single coffee and put a £10 note, even a £20 note on the counter, and said to them, okay, if you can't handle change, if you're scared of my currency, I think you better keep the change. And they don't know what to do. They really don't know what to do. They look embarrassed. They usually try and tell me, look, just take the coffee, it's okay. But I will make a point of putting a big note on in front of them. Just to let them know that I did try and pay. Anyway, I'm rambling on a bit now. Sorry about this, guys. I just want to fill up some time on my video. But anyway, as I said, Southwark Crown Court, where Nacho is right now. Crazy times, and just here to show my support really, and if there's any updates I'll let you know, but otherwise enjoy your day and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now, love and freedom.